Dr. Manu Chadda or Madam Manu, as we fondly call her, needs no introduction. She is a well-known figure in teacher education community. Let's have a brief introduction about her. Dr. Manu is a postgraduate in chemistry and psychology. She did her PhD in education from Punjab University, Chandigarh, and got the award for youngest research scholar by CTE in 2005. She has a vast research experience. She published 76 research papers and articles in national and international journals. She has a bulk of paper presentations in national and international conferences, seminars, and workshops. She has conducted more than 20 extension lectures on various themes. She also edited 3 books on teacher education. She has also published 1 scale on workplace stress, which is available at National Psychological Corporation, Agra. She is also an active member of various educational organizational bodies like CTE, GARA, AIAER, and PCCTU. She is a registered career counselor appointed by Punjab School Education Board. She is continuously giving her career counseling services to nearby school students. 10 students have completed their PhD under her able guidance, and 4 more are pursuing. She is currently working on 2 research projects on teacher education sponsored by UGC and Punjab University, Chandigarh. And at the last but not the least, and which I think is the above all the degrees and credentials, she is a nice human being with a helping hand and love and compassion for everyone. Now it's over to Dr. Manu Chadda.
Thank you, Dr. Jasbir, for the beautiful words. I'm highly grateful to you for these words. Today, life is becoming much stressful. In the era of threat for security of life due to pandemics, epidemics, huge competition and race for being ahead, we have started ignoring our health and immunity. Sports, games, mindful eating, certainly play a huge role in transforming our routine health. My co-presenters have very beautifully given us inputs regarding all this. It provides us happiness and energy, no doubt, for better work performance, but still an optimistic, healthy environment supplements more to our well-being at workplace. So, well, friends, my topic for today is well-being at workplace. Now, before I start my topic, I would just like to ask a few questions. I would be posing a poll. Please remember one thing, none of the questions are right or wrong. They are simply your observations, your opinions. And mind you, I will not be getting your names or your results or something. I'll be just getting the percentage as Madam Jasleen had got. So starting with my poll before I proceed so that I just get an idea of the various strategies that we need to apply for carrying out, for creating positive well-being at workplace. So please be ready for the polls. I hope the poll is visible to you on your screen. Is the poll visible on your screen? Okay. Hanji. The first question, are the goals and responsibilities in your institution clearly communicated to you? You just have to answer in yes or no. Third institution, jo bhi koi kaam ho rahe hai, jehde koi goals hai, responsibilities hai, are they communicated to you? Are you told in advance or are they through some kind of message are they sent to you? Kindly respond. Oh, sorry. Second question, does your job stress you? The third question, after you go back home from your workplace, you think you are stressed? Next question, are you acknowledged for your work at your workplace? Yes or no? I'm getting amazing results. That's beautiful. And do you hold yourself responsible for the progress or failure at your workplace? That's great. So, well, my friends, I'll just wait for another few seconds so that I can get more results. The participants who raised your hands, can you just type your queries in the chat box? Okay, so I think I'll end the poll here, and we can just discuss over the answers. Thank you, friends. Thank you for your amazing participation. Okay, so are the goals and responsibilities in your institution clearly communicated to you? 89% of you have said yes, while, 90% has said yes, while 11% has said no. Please end the poll. So 90% of you have said yes, you are the goals and responsibilities in your institution are clearly communicated to you. This indicates, this particular poll indicates employee happiness. This indicates that you exhibit a sufficient amount of employee happiness. My second question, does your job stress you? 68% of you have beautifully mentioned, no, it does not stress you. Okay, so this indicates that you are actually getting good employee well-being. You're a good employer who is getting good well-being in the institute. Third question, do you feel stressed after you are back home from your workplace? 61% of you say, no, you're not stressed, which is a wonderful thing. Again, this question says, ghar aakar agar aap thakan nahi feel kar rahe, to ye bhi yehi batata hai ki aap ek achhi employee, aap as an employee ek achhi well-being exhibit kar rahe ho. Next question, are you acknowledged for your work at place, your workplace? 83%. Wonderful. This shows you're all working at beautiful places. So you all actually have positive well-being at your workplace. This is shows that employee well-being. You show positive well-being. Besides that, you also are positively engaged in your work. Fifth question, do you hold yourself responsible for the progress or failure at your workplace? 82% of you have said yes. So it may be either progress or failure. In both the cases, it means that you are the pivot of your institution. Again, this question deals with employee engagement. So five of these questions are actually indicative of employee happiness, employee well-being. So I'll end the poll here, please. Share. These are indicative of employee happiness, employee well-being, and employee engagement. Now, what is basically employee happiness? Employee happiness doesn't mean that you're just feeling happy all the time. It is actually a feeling of optimism about your work. It is your ability to fix the problems. And when I say your ability to fix the problems, remember one thing, we're only able to fix the problems when we are actually willing to fix those problems. Sara time rote ro, oh Lord, now what will happen? Corona is there. I cannot go there. My kids are not going to school. I have so much work to do. I know we were all facing these problems. But when you are able to fix these problems, when you are able to, when you are willing to deal with these problems, and when you have the capacity to accept criticism, and that also I can say constructive criticism, then I can say you move towards improving oneself. And this is basically what is called as employee happiness. My second and third question, as I said, deals with employee well-being. Now, what basically is employee well-being? Employee well-being is about how your job, your duties, your expectations, stress level at your workplace, the environment at your workplace, it actually affects your overall health and happiness. It's certainly the factors responsible for our well-being are exercise and nutrition, but more than that, it's your mood, it's your cognition. These are the less tangible factors which are also responsible for the well-being of an employee. My last two questions, as I said, show, since the positive results show that you are engaged in your institution. Yesterday, Dr. Shruti Shauri had also talked about engagement. Now, engagement basically means when the workforce at the workplace, they feel that the work they are doing is meaningful. Their work is valued. Their work is appreciated. It is supported, then we can say they have higher well-being levels. They seem to be more committed towards, and this will result in more commitment towards the organization's goal, and surely you're going to perform better. So friends, the strong relationship between your well-being, your motivation, and your performance in the institution is known as employee engagement. These three terms, employee happiness, employee well-being, employee engagement, they are all used interchangeably. They basically, we use them often, but they have some difference. What is the difference we've already seen, and what strategies to be employed that we're going to see? Here, I'm going to basically focus on employee well-being, because I feel when an individual is engaged, when an individual is happy at his workplace, obviously, we can say he or she enjoys positive, good well-being. Friends, smart employers, that is your heads, know that the organizations perform better when the staff is happy, healthy, motivated, and focused. Now, what are the factors that are going to trigger stress and mental health problems before that? Okay. Now, one question I would like to ask you, what is health? We've all been studying this. What is health? Can I have your answers in the chat box? Can you please, just in a nutshell, it's not test, just what do you think? What do you mean by health? Okay, very good. Okay, so as plenty of you have said, it is physical health, it is mental health. Just as physical health, we have mental health also. It also moves up and down. We have it. It also moves from good to bad. It is, we can say that since considering the amount of time we spend at work, which is generally 7 to 8 hours officially, but we are also working more than that. So I can say during these pandemic days, the amount of time that we are spending in our offices, in our schools, in our institutions is basically, I can say, around 10 to 12 hours. So considering the amount of time that we spend at work, it is actually the workplace environment and the work culture that affects your work well-being. So long hours, no breaks, unrealistic expectations or deadlines, especially in the MNCs, you see that you just given 1 or 2 days and you have to finish a big project. Then a poor physical working environment. Then at times you're even designated roles, you are given position, you're given some roles to perform. Aapko koi aisa kaam de diya jata hai, which again are high risk roles. You don't know whether, because the progress also is because of you and the failure is also because of you. You'll be held responsible. At times over a big project, you're made to work all alone. So lone working. And when you're working alone, it means difficult interpersonal relationships. You don't have very good interpersonal relations among your friends. And as such, you're not able, you lack internal communication. Because yesterday, as ma'am had also said, it is very important that we need to have a good communication along the hierarchy from the lower level to the staff members, to the principal, to the managing directors, and to the heads. Everybody, you need to have a good hierarchy. So when you lack that poor internal communication, it means that you are not getting enough managerial support. And a very important factor during pandemic, during this critical time, is job insecurity. Plenty of you are facing insecurity in job, poorly managed change. So these are some of the factors that trigger stress and mental health problems at workplace. Now, before we take up, yesterday ma'am had also quoted about Maslow's need hierarchy. Well, friends, this is a pyramid which shows that the difference that we have as the different needs that we need to have as humans. The bottom of the pyramid shows those needs which are very important, which are the life-sustaining needs. Roti, kapda, makan, your family, your social interactions, your security. These are the needs that we need to fulfill. These are our basic needs. Once these basic needs are fulfilled, then only you can move towards the higher level of the top of the pyramid. The top of the pyramid shows that once these basic, and achieve those basic needs, needs at the top of the pyramid, you actually need to fulfill the needs at the bottom. And it is here that the wellness works. It is here that wellness works. So friends, not everyone gets a chance to fulfill these higher needs. Not everyone gets a chance that they are able, that their lives can be as rewarding as everybody can have. So here it is. Henceforth, I think we need to first make efforts to fulfill the needs at the bottom, go to the top, and then it is there that wellness works. So whether it be corona, whether it be any pandemic, any epidemic, we see that people with comorbidities are likely to be more prone to diseases. They are likely to be more exerted, and hence they exhibit poor well-being. Now my question is, why? So to have a positive well-being, we all know we need to have positive or good health behaviors. Now why do we need to generate or improve our health behaviors? As you all know, people who have good health behaviors, who are able to maintain healthy behaviors, will surely show positive well-being. When they will show pure positive well-being, which means that they will be suffering less diseases. They will be suffering from less diseases, less chronic diseases. Ab agar bimariyan nahi hongi, to aapko doctor ke paas nahi jana padega. Doctor ke paas nahi jaoge, to means less healthcare costs. So this in turn, I can say, is responsible for your well-being. And then if you have all these three, it means you show good well-being. Another thing, if you show positive well-being, obviously, you're going to show improvement in your work. So good well-being results in improved productivity. Employees with good health behavior, they have the capability of controlling their stress. They are prone to less comorbidities. They can control their problems. As such, I will say that they show poor or less absenteeism. They'll be coming regularly for work, less likely to be absent from work. Then another very important factor why we need to improve our health behaviors. If we improve our health behaviors, it is obvious that we will see that the workplace where we are working, we're going to find that there is good recruitment, there employee recruitment and employee retention. Now, what basically is retention? Retention here is the ability of the workplace to retain workforce. हम अक्सर ये सुनते हैं उस इंस्टीट्यूट में बहुत पुराने टीचर्स बैठे हैं, उस इंस्टीट्यूट में बहुत पुराने लोग बैठे हैं. What is the basic reason? वहाँ पुराने लोग क्यों बैठे हैं? पुराने लोग इसलिए बैठे हैं क्योंकि वो वर्कप्लेस जो है वो बहुत ज्यादा अच्छा एटमोस्फियर है वहाँ पर. The workforce is very comfortable there and as a result it will help the employees in building a strong high morale, in building a strong it's a good morale in working over. Okay, then there is another important factor that is responsible, and that factor basically is, now we see that if you can all see this the research study published by a journal, we can see that people who use tobacco, 28%, and 66% are those who are not healthy, and 50% are those who do not exercise, do not perform any exercise. We can see that this is the rate of presentism. Now, what basically is presentism? Absenteeism, you were all very clear, that is remaining absent from work. Presentism doesn't mean just that being present at work. We are physically at work, but actually not working. And this is called presentism. And you find that all these unhealthy lifestyles are responsible for our poor productivity at work. And this is what I mean by presentism. So the results have also shown that it is unhealthy lifestyles. And when it is unhealthy lifestyles, obviously when your lifestyle, Jasleen had just talked about mindfulness in eating, Chetan had talked about physical exercise. And I feel that in case we are not mindful about all these things, we are not healthy. And once we are not healthy, we are not productive at work. We may be there at work, but we're not productive at work. And this poor productivity is called presentism. And basically, one main cause of presentism is poor health. So friends, I think for our positive well-being, we need to focus on all of them. Now, well, friends, when I was just going through the registration list, since you all know that I was there in the organizing committee also. So when I was just going through the registration list, I could see I have plenty of principals, plenty of heads on board in my list. And so, although I think I'm not in a position to guide them, but I don't think so that a tip here or there is going to hurt them. Due apologies to the various principals and to the heads, but just a few tips which might help you, which might be of some help to you. Okay. I was just going through an article by Sonja in the How of Happiness, where it very, very beautifully quoted that 50% of the happiness is genetically predetermined. And it is 10%, which is because of the circumstances of life. When I say your circumstances in life, I mean your family, your friends, your health, etc. So all these. Now, humni dan 60%. It is only the 40% that is your personal outlook. And my dear principals, my dear heads, as an employer, you really cannot do anything with the top two, that is the 60%, but you surely can help your employees in improving upon the 40%, that is their personal outlook. And here you can do this by bringing about a change in the structure of the work pattern, structure of their daily work pattern. So now, how you can bring about a change in the structure of the daily work pattern? Employers, that is the principals, the heads, should send a clear message that the well-being of the staff matters to them. Colleagues always take cues from their leaders. As kids learn from their parents, so here, as an employee, we all learn from our employers. So when the head speaks about the mental health, it actually has a huge impact on the workforce. Then secondly, in many institutions, in many workplaces, mental health is just an elephant in the room. Too often, employees are scared to go and talk to their principals. They're scared to go and talk to their heads. And what happens? Sari jo problem hai, that turns out to be that becomes a problem. And the problems keep on aggravating. Gunjaldar hote hote badhti jati hai. So here the employers need to raise the awareness and promote discussion of mental health and well-being to proactively challenge the harmful culture which is presently there during pandemic. Because as it is, we are all under stress because of the pandemic. We are under stress because we do not know the future. We are under stress because we are not aware of the future of our kids. They're not going to schools and we do not know what is going to happen with their studies. So there's so much workload as parents, as employees. So here I think it is the employers who can help us in promoting the mental health and well-being among their employees. Another thing, I think at the beginning of the session, in almost all the institutes, and even these days, we're all into having FDPs and training programs. And very important, mental health programs can be embedded in these induction and training programs. The staff can be involved in dialogues, in internal communication, in decision making. Another very good thing that I feel is a small thank you note, a formal recognition. Or in some of the MNCs we've seen the banks, when we go in the bank, we have an Employee of the Month award. This goes a long way towards creating a more positive emotional environment, and it really supports, it really helps out. So this was what your heads can do for you. But well, friends, heads cannot do everything. It is actually this positive well-being has to come from within yourself. You have to boost well-being within yourself. Bahar se aapko kitna marzi acha environment provide karne, lekin agar aapko hi aadat hai rone ki, aapko hi aadat hai crip karne ki, ki main kya karun, mere upar ghar ka kaam ka bahut bojh hai, ya this or that, whatever. Your heads cannot do anything for you in that case. I said they can just work on that 40%. But friends, 60% is in your hands. So for that 60%, very important is, which all my co-presenters have already been speaking. Dr. Shruti Shauri was beautiful yesterday. She's an amazing speaker. I cannot say anything about her. You all were listening to her. So she talked about mindfulness. Chetan talked about physical mindfulness. And Jasleen has just given you beautiful tips about mindful eating. So practice mindfulness. May it be through physical exercises. What you need to do is reduce your stress and enhance your relationships. Yesterday, ma'am had said, once in a while, I don't think so. I know we cannot go out. Corona mein aap ek dusre ke ghar nahi ja sakte ho, lekin aap itna to kar sakte ho ki aap ek phone call kar lo apne neighbors ko. You can just divide your time. Today I'm going to call 3 neighbors. Tomorrow I'm going to call next 3 neighbors. Then I'm going to call my relatives. I'm going to call some oldies in my relations. That is going to enhance your relationship. Another, guided meditation. A meditation doesn't mean ki jaakar Himalaya pe baithkar meditate karna. Meditation basically means talking within yourself. Know yourself. You just have to think about yourself. Think of all the good things that you do. Think of all the good things that you have. We thank you for all that you have. Yesterday, ma'am had also talked about gratitude. May it be after your meditation. May it be early in the morning when you get up. When you get up, you just sit on your bed. Keep a notebook next to your bed. Or may it be at night. Just track a 2-minute gratitude list. Thank you for all this. Thank you for this. Thank you for this. Thank you for this. And you see your list will keep on increasing as the days pass. And then you realize you'll have so much positive. You have so many good things around you. Then why crib and complain? Then you will not crib and complain. Obviously, you'll have a good well-being. Then fitness challenges. I don't think so. I need to talk much about it. We had a full session on it yesterday. Encourage employees to develop friendships. Again here, let's have a very cool environment at the workplace. Enhance group work. Cooperative strategies, adopt karo. Is tarah se kaam karo that every individual's work is commended, and also along with that individual's work, even the overall work, it also affects the every individual's work is commended, and it adds to the score of the team. It adds to the score of the whole team. Then another, learn to improve your patience. Learn to improve your communication. When I say communication, it doesn't mean ki aise baatein karna. Communication is also non-vocal communication. Communication means communicating within yourself. Improvements in your analytical thinking. Yesterday, ma'am talked about engagement. Even my my questions in the poll were about engagement. And engagement is an all-time low, and one beautiful way to encourage yourself that yes, you care about your job. You care about your work. Feel safe at your workplace. Feel supported at your workplace. Feel appreciated at your workplace. Don't just keep waiting ki mujhe bola jayega ki aap to bahut acha kaam karte hain. Aap khud hi apne kaam ko lekar khush ho jao. आप खुद ही अपने काम को एनालाइज करो, बिकॉज आई जस्ट सेड इंप्रूवमेंट्स इन योर एनालिटिकल थिंकिंग. एंड व्हेन इट कम्स टू एनालिटिकल थिंकिंग, आई मीन सेल्फ एनालिटिकल थिंकिंग. डोंट स्टार्ट एनालाइजिंग अदर्स. प्लीज एनालाइज योरसेल्फ एंड यू विल लव योर वर्क. एंड व्हेन यू लव योर वर्क, यू लव योर वर्क प्लेस. यू लव योर वर्क प्लेस, ऑब्वियसली पॉजिटिव वेलबींग एट योर वर्क प्लेस. सोशल इंटरेक्शंस. डोंट जस्ट, आई नो इट इज कोरोना टाइम, वी ऑल नीड टू बी अवे फ्रॉम ईच अदर. We need to maintain social distance, but then along with the social distance, we can also maintain interactions. We can encourage friendship among each other. This is basically, when you talk to your friends, I personally think, I really love talking to my friends, and till I don't talk, I am full with everything, because I think it helps me in decreasing my stress. It helps me in reducing my anxiety. It is a very important factor in enhancing happiness and bringing about calmness within me. So basically, you need to. So where do we start? Please don't wait that it has to come from anywhere else. It has to come from within you. It has to be from within you. Then yesterday, ma'am talked about a very important term, that is connectionism. Connectionism again is very important factor for well-being. Now, how can we encourage, how can we facilitate connectionism among ourselves at the workplace? How, as co-workers, we can encourage connectionism? Best way is, there should be generally everywhere, be it any school, any college, be it any workplace, lunch break zarur hota hai. It is mandatory. It is in that rules of work. Encourage co-workers to take their full lunch break and try taking it together. Let it be in a big hall, in a dining hall. You may eat your own food. You don't have to share your food. That is not mandatory. But at least when you're all together, you will eat your lunch and with little chit-chats. Although here I am going against what Jasleen said, focus on your lunch. But then I think we need to de-stress ourselves also during our workplace. Encourage team traditions and rituals. अब हम लोग सब अलग अलग कल्चर से आते हैं. किसी भी एक वर्क प्लेस में वी आर पीपल फ्रॉम डिफरेंट एरियाज, डिफरेंट फील्ड्स. सो व्हाई नॉट सेलिब्रेट ईच वन्स डे. each festival. See, every small festival, why not celebrate that? Why not celebrate every small ritual? It's just going to take 5 to 10 minutes. You don't have to go in with all the decoration, with all spending money or this, but it can be just very small thing. Supposing it is my culture's day today, I can just get something very, whatever is there in my culture, I can make it and get it in the, get it to my office, and during lunch we can all share that. Just make it with, send it, give it to all my friends. Then another thing, which we are all presently doing it, allow remote days. Remote days means I am not well, I am stressed, I can work from home, which is a very good practice in MNCs. We always thought that teaching is not possible. Teaching is not possible from home. I was always under the impression, I used to always tell the software engineers and all, you can work from home, but we cannot. But this pandemic has made us realize nothing is impossible. Impossible is actually a word in the dictionary of fools. Impossible, we are all working from home. Besides that, we can even work from some offsite location. I'm working on a project and I think I'm not able to concentrate in my room. I'm not able to concentrate in the staff room or in my room. I can go and sit in the coffee shop. I can go and sit in the student center and work there. I can go and sit in the playground and just work upon it. So it's not necessary that the work has to be done in those four corners only. It's not that closed compartment mein hi kaam ho sakta hai. Aap kahin bhi jahan aapko distraction nahi ho rahi aur aap apne kaam par focus kar sakte ho. Then start an offsite office-wide Slack channel. This we are all doing it. We all have WhatsApp groups, official where we have our office WhatsApp groups. Let there be one official WhatsApp group. Let there be another unofficial WhatsApp group of your workplace where you can discuss things unofficially. Then focus on personal development. As I said, it is very important that it has to come from within you. Set your own goals, set your own work strategies. Ma'am yesterday talked about resilience, bounce back. So you need to do that, reduce your burnout. Another thing, if you're sick, stay away from work. It is not, if you're sick, it's not a sign of weakness. It is actually, you need some rest and you can always work from home. So that this again will help you. Then another, at home, I think all of us, after a few months, we feel like bringing about some changes in our room. We'll move the bed from here to there. We'll do something or the other. Please do that in your office also. There's no hard and fast rule that you cannot change the setting of your office. You can always move your table from here to there, or you can bring about some, and in case financial conditions of your office allow, you can remove the wooden windows, you can remove the wooden doors, let there be aluminium doors with sufficient glass so that sunlight comes in. Allow more sunlight to come. Chetan yesterday talked about circadian rhythms. Natural light influences our circadian rhythms, our natural clocks, the 24/7 natural clocks, the sleep and wake cycles. So all these factors, I think we can do it ourselves. I don't think so. If you move your table or your chair from one position to the other, your HOD or your employer will not come and say, "Yahan se yahan kyun kiya? Hai to aap kamre mein hi ho. Waise to aapne agar kaam karna hai, to aap thodi der ke liye bahar jaakar bhi kaam kar sakte hain to remove your distractions." But try renovating your office. Try bringing about a change in your office without spending much money. Please, I would not say that you renovate it completely, because then all the employers are going to shout at me. You can always do that even without spending much money. Allow sunlight, sufficient sunlight to come. So friends, for a supportive environment, for the major key parameters in well-being and at our workplace, major parameters to have a good well-being at a workplace, we need to have positive working relations. We need to have a supportive environment, work environment, and we need to be socially involved. So for that, you need to be at your workplace, please be mutually supportive. Don't say this is your job, you do it. If you know it, please help out. Don't think that it is her job, it is his job. Why should I interfere? Mera naam to aana nahi hai yahan par, main kyun karun? No. Please be mutually supportive. Have a good environment where good work relationships thrive. Encourage good teamwork. Support a culture of teamwork, collaboration, and information sharing. These are just the key takeaways which I feel that you can just understand. The very simple. Promote positive behavior. Avoid conflicts. Avoid stress-giving factors in the institute or in your workplace. We all have anti-grievance cells. We all have sexual harassment cells all over, in any, whether it is any kind of workplace, we all have it there. But please ensure that these policies are not there just in paper and pen. They are well in place, well publicized. Encourage exercise. Encourage regular social events. I don't think so there will be a problem if a workplace, probably all the MNCs do have it, I'm very sure of it. Our college itself also has it. We have a very small gym here where I remember when we are there with stress, we can go there. Treadmill ke upar thodi der exercise kar lo, cycling kar lo, kuch aisa kar lo jahan par aap apna stress remove kar sakte ho. Then I've just given one idea of lunch and learn, which I've already told you. We can all sit together. And lunchtime is 30 minutes, 15 to 15 minutes. We can all sit and have lunch together. Next 15 minutes, just take a walk in the ground, in your lawns, in your ground, whatever you have it in your workplace. And then you can discuss about various things. Try avoiding the discussion that is to be about some project, but let there be a discussion. An indirect discussion. Promote good work-life balance. Please prioritize yourself first. Your development is more important. If you are developed, if you are engaged, then only you will be able to bring about employee happiness. You will be able to bring about well-being. You'll be able to bring about engagement. Please ensure, be a very good listener. We all love talking, and especially teaching profession, it's wonderful talking. But please be a good listener also and ensure that the voices of the people with mental health problems are heard. Try to hear them. So friends, starting from my introductory statement where I started yesterday, before introducing Dr. Shruti Shaurya, I think I started from this statement. So starting from my introductory statement, remember positivity pulls you up and never lets you drown. We must remember that we are all children of God and He will never let us drown. What He only asks us is that keep your thoughts positive. Let us all be optimistic. It can be achieved by feeding ourselves, besides feeding with food, besides feeding with all the love, laughter, humanity. It can be by feeding ourselves with spirituality, mindfulness, meditation, prayer, and good thoughts. So friends, let's all re-begin our journey as we come into we come to the end of this webinar today. Let's all re-begin our journey by being more compassionate and progressive human beings. I am born with potential. I am born with confidence. I am born with wings. So I'm not meant for crawling. I have wings, I will fly and fly. So please keep that I will in you. When you have that I will in you, surely you can do it. So in the middle of this chaos, there is a life to be celebrated. Let's celebrate this life with cheer and passion. Thank you, friends. Thank you for your patient hearing. We can have the a few of the hands were being raised, but since I could not unmute them, we can have the questions now.
Thank you.